your final keynote speaker, came to us directly from Nigeria to speak with you all today. And I mean literally came here to New York City, two sisters in sales, to speak to each of you. So I am excited to introduce to you Juliet Ehemua. Bring it back. I think. Come on out, yes. Because as she comes out here and dance, I'm gonna tell you all about who she is. Because this is the other thing. I was saying to someone else earlier, Juliet, but I was told that, you know, as black women, we don't always stand in our authority fully. So I wanna, while this woman is standing next to me, Dr. Juliet Ehemua.
Very well done.
You know, I'm excited. I'm like, give me that praise. Is a renowned tech industry leader with over 25 years of experience, including a remarkable 12 years at Google, primarily as a director for West Africa. We see all of our lovely West Africans here. We love it. Myself included, ancestrally. She established and expanded Google's presence in Nigeria and the wider West Africa region, fostering innovation and strategic partnerships. Juliet is a respected thought leader, coach, and advocate for personal excellence and leadership, and obviously a great dancer, too. And she was named by Forbes as one of the top 20 power women in Africa by the London Business School, as one of 30 people changing the entire world. So we're standing next to the woman, okay? I am so excited to introduce to you this wonderful woman, Dr. Juliet Ehemua, featured in BBC Africa Power Women series and on CNN Innovate. Juliet.
Thank you so much. Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Have you had a good day so far?
Yes.
Fantastic. I'm really excited to be here and to be sharing this time with you. And I know it's been a long day, a very productive day, but a long day nonetheless. And I know I'm standing between you and happy hour, but this is the closing keynote, and it's also an integral part of the program design. So we're not just wrapping up, we're going to be sharing some new insights. So even if you're tired, can't wait to just wrap up and go home, please stay with me. Let's do this together. We're still on the journey. Yes, yes? Fantastic. And it's great to be in a room filled with strong, determined, professional women of color in the sales industry. And from my personal opinion, I think sales is really the bedrock of a lot of things that we do. We're always selling. If I think about my 25 plus years career, I can't think of a time when I wasn't selling. It doesn't matter what role I was in, right? Even in a partnerships role, I was selling the prospect of a great partnership, right? I was selling the benefits, the, you know, win-win relationship that is possible. And you can have a great vision, but if you're unable to sell it, it's dead in the water. And so even selling to ourselves, because sometimes you have an aspiration and you need to first even sell that to yourself to say, I deserve this, it is possible, I'm going to go for it. So selling is actually something that we do on an ongoing basis. And I believe that we're all here because we're looking to raise our game in different ways. And that's fantastic because as human beings, growth and development is something that is really constant and something that we should continue to embrace. I also love the theme for this event, We Are Here. That is really a statement of fact that we matter, that we cannot be ignored, that we are going to be visible. And what I love more about that is not just that we are here, what is the impact of our being here? We're here, we're able to realize our potential, we're able to influence and inspire other people, we're able to create a positive impact by virtue of our being here. We leave our mark, we leave our legacy. And the reality is, as human beings, we've come a long way. If you think about it, it may interest you to know that your smartphone, a device that fits in the palm of your hands, has more computing power than the technology that put a man on the moon in 1969. That's how far we've come as human beings. And even putting a man on the moon, there was a time when that would have been considered crazy and impossible. But increasingly, we're seeing what seems impossible, possible. This morning, there was a session on AI, generative AI, and all the possibilities. In parts of Africa at the moment, we have subsistence farmers being able to automatically detect crop diseases just by loading an app on their phones, an app that is powered by machine learning. So we're seeing a lot of accelerated growth and things that would seem impossible, possible. And in the last 25 plus years, I've spent a lot of time in tech and leadership, worked in some of the largest organizations, and also as an entrepreneur. And I have been a student and a teacher of excellence. I have surveyed over hundreds of businesses and startup leaders, and also every year I coach hundreds of people. And something that I've always been interested by is just really understanding what differentiates one person from the other. How is it that some people are able to go from hope and dreams to realization of that hope and that dream? How is it that people are able to go from good to great or very good to excellent? What is that X factor? What is that thing that really makes a difference? And that's an essential part of what I'm looking to share as part of this keynote. We've heard some great things in the today, even last night as well at the gala. We'll be hearing some more tomorrow. And I believe we're all here because we're interested in raising our game. How do we take everything that we've heard, shared, and apply those to actually help us along that path tomorrow, next week, next quarter, next year? For that reason, the theme of my talk is going to be stepping into the future with courage and excellence. And from all the conversations I've had, observing others and also just really observing myself and my journey, there are three things that I'd like to leave you with as we think about really manifesting the goals and the dreams that we have deep seated within us. Those three things, I call them the three B's. It's be intentional, be focused, and be unstoppable. And I'm going to talk very briefly on each of these. But starting with excellence, when we talk about excellence, we're all called to excellence, but what does that mean? There's a traditional definition of excellence that we're all familiar with. You know, ticking the boxes, delivering high quality results, you know, being a super salesperson, for example, hitting those targets and those goals and just really knocking it out of the park. But there's another definition of excellence, a deeper meaning that is internally driven. You may be ticking all the boxes, but you may know within you that you can be and do so much more, that you haven't realized your full potential. There's something within us as human beings that seeks constant expansion and fulfillment. We all have our dreams and visions within us. And in this context, excellence is about something that is internally driven, where we're aiming high, not because there's some external force or targets that are nudging us in that direction, but because of the dreams and the visions that are inside of us. Manifesting and just really bringing those to the foreground, being the best versions of ourselves. That's what it points down to at the end of the day, being the best versions of ourselves. Because each and every one of us is immensely talented, and we owe it to ourselves to shine as fully as we can. And so when we talk about being intentional, that's the first B. Everything in life starts with an intention. This building, for example, we have this amazing building, we see the ceilings, we see the glass. This all started in the mind of someone. And then it was put on paper or a computer. And then eventually we had this structure built. Creation always starts in the mind. And as human beings, we have such strong creative potential. Whether we realize it or not, we're constantly creating our reality. We're influencing how our lives emerge. We can be creating consciously or unconsciously. Those are the two choices. And being deliberate about going after what we want, being intentional, puts us in a space where we can create consciously. And we've seen this in our lives, in our work, right? We know the difference between, you know, just being very clear that this is the outcome I'm going for. This is the result I'm going for. This is the reason why. These are the benefits, right? The kind of energy and mobilization that we have when we have that level of clarity. Because creation, doesn't matter what, always starts in the mind. And we've seen that as human beings, we've created amazing things. You know, AI, taking a man to the moon, all kinds of things. Those were creations from the human mind. So how much more being able to create those dreams and visions that are inside of us? In my coaching experience, I do recall, it was really memorable because it was very profound. I was speaking to a lady who shared the fact that she had just celebrated her 60th birthday, and someone said to her, "See you at 70. And she said she cringed. It was a reflex reaction, but she realized that she really cringed. And she said, "Who wants to be here at 70? And she realized that she had no vision for 70. In her experience, life was hard. Life was difficult, right? It was a struggle. And she listed a number of things where she thinks humanity, we take two steps forward and five steps backwards and all of that. And she just realized that her relationship with life, she had no vision for 70, right? She was just going through the motions. And we went through that conversation, and in the end, she created a new vision. And that vision was, "I am in love with life again." And that transformed her outlook. She became lighter, and these are her own words. She became lighter and felt more energized to go after things. Rather than just going through the motion, she was in a space where she felt, "Yes, I can create all these great things. I can design the life that I love, such that I am in love with life again." We know what it feels like when you have something you're aspiring to. For example, let me take a very simple example. If you're going on holiday, maybe next week or this weekend, whenever you remember, there's a certain motivation that you have. It encourages you. Even if you have to work very hard for the next 2 days, in your mind, you're like, "Okay, at the end of this, I have this holiday." That's what a vision does for us. It just really pulls us and helps us to direct our energies. And I do recall, in my journey, when I started out at Google about 12 years ago, there were just two of us in a small room in a serviced building. And, you know, we had the task of taking an organization that had a global reputation, but with very little local footprint, right? And it was important for us to be intentional, to have a very clear vision, which at the time we articulated as making Google work for the market and making the market work for Google. So looking at how we could bring the best of the organization to the market, but also how we could show the potential, the opportunities, the results that can be created in the market for Google. We also had a unified purpose because, you know, the region is 1.2 billion people, Nigeria is 200 million people, big numbers, right? So we had a purpose, which was make the numbers count. And we were unified around that purpose. And you know, as the team expanded, we all imbibed this purpose, make the numbers count. And we went on to, we were the first region that provided digital skills training for 1 million people. Following that, we were able to get support to do 10 million and a lot of other initiatives and projects. But that was because we had that clarity of vision to start with. Now, I'm going to ask you guys, in different areas of life, because life exists in different domains. There's work, there's family, there's physical well-being, emotional well-being, finances. Who has a clearly articulated vision in an area of life? Can I see a show of hands? Some people are not sure, maybe, maybe not. But it seems like maybe about 40% of the room. Okay, so next question. Who has it written down? This is typical, but well done. For those of you that have your hands up, well done, because, and these are the ratios. Whenever I ask this question, these are the ratios. Because these are simple concepts. We all know what a vision is. We've all heard about this, right? But it's in the application of these concepts that we really experience the power. So one takeaway I will leave with you in around being intentional is take some time after this and reflect. Pick an area of life. It could be any of those domains I talked about, family, work, physical well-being, etc. Just pick an area and, you know, in your mind, visualize, create that mental picture. What is it I want to have? What is it I want to create? Who do I desire to be as a sales professional, for example? Right? What kind of impact do I want? How do I want my career to grow, to evolve, right? So that we're intentional in going after those goals. And there are three things I would recommend as we go through that exercise to ensure that we're doing it properly and landing in the right place. The first is just be bold and audacious. Life is for the bold, not for the faint-hearted. Be bold to be able to serve that which you are called to. So it's not about being bold and audacious just for the sake of it, or dreaming up something big just for the sake of it. It's about giving honor to those things that are inside that you may have suppressed because you feel, I don't know how this is going to happen. Who am I kidding, right? I'm too timid. Right? I'm not from the right side of town, or I don't have a sponsor, so I don't see how this can happen. And the different reasons that we give ourselves. Let's be bold and audacious to actually articulate that vision. The second thing is focus on the what and the why, but not the how. Because if you focus on the how, I can guarantee you're most likely to limit yourself, because then we start to see all the reasons why it may not work. I don't see a precedence for this. I've never done this. How am I going to make this happen? So to focus on the what and the why, but not the how. The how will come later. And then the third thing is to write it down. It can be in our heads. We have that picture. It's fuzzy and it shifts. But when you write it down, there's a certain concreteness that comes to it. And so writing it down, and I would say writing it down in the present tense, because even though there's something futuristic about your vision, ideally you should be living into your vision on a daily basis. The choices you make, how you choose to spend your time, who you interact with, these can all be informed by your vision. And so writing it down in the present tense, rather than I will have, I have, because you're bringing it into your experience. The second B is about being focused. By the way, before I go into that, how does that sound about the exercise? Fantastic. Because it's great to attend programs like this and listen to great things, but we still have to do the work. And part of doing that work is taking time out to reflect, okay, what do I want to create? You know? Looking at if it doesn't need to be time bound, but sometimes time can help us crystallize it. For the rest of the year, what is my outlook? Because then we can be deliberate about going after it. Which brings us to the next bit, which is being focused. We know that life is increasingly complex. There are so many things competing for our time and attention. And you may have heard the saying that what you focus on expands. If you focus on something, you give it your energy. A lot of us complain about time, that we don't have enough time to do all the things we want to do. The reality is, time management is very much about around priority management. We don't have enough hours in the day to do things that don't matter. And once we call out our intention, our vision, that helps us to decide what needs to be in and what needs to be out. Perhaps there's an activity that is a drain on my time, but doesn't really take me from A to B. In the scheme of what I'm about in life, what I'm looking to create, it doesn't really do anything for me. Perhaps I want to put that aside and create space to bring in other things that can move me forward. We said in creating the vision, focus on the what, not the how. Once we've articulated the vision, the next step is to focus on the how. That's when we start to look at, okay, what do I need to do to make this happen? And that requires focus. And the caveat there as well is the fact that all the answers don't have to come from you. That's why we have communities. That's why, you know, the Sisters in Sales community is a great one, and many other communities. That's why we have friends, we have relationships, and so on. That's why we have social media and other tools as well, to see who has walked the path that I'm looking to walk. Who are the people I can learn from? Maybe there's a course I need to enroll for. You know, what are those things I need to do concretely to move me forward from A to B? And what are the things that I need to weed out to create space for the substance to grow? So focus is a big aspect of this. And the final B is be unstoppable. And this is about courage. Life is a lesson in courage. To go after your dreams requires courage. Sometimes to even articulate those dreams requires courage, especially when they are bold and audacious. My late mother, she passed about 5 years ago, she used to say, it's not the life that matters, but the courage you put into it. That was her way of saying, it's not about what happens to you, you know? Things can happen that you can't really control or predict. But how do you pick yourself up and keep moving forward? How do you put on a cloak of courage every day and forge ahead? And I saw her do that many times, right? There were times when I thought, gosh, where do you get that strength from? But she would always put on the cloak of courage and soldier on. Because we know that there are things in life that we can't control. There are certain things that are within our control, but there are many things. We can't control what people do necessarily. We can try to influence what people do, but we don't have that control. But there's one thing that every human being has control over, and that is how we choose to respond to situations. It may be that you've done your homework and it just rains on your picnic. You can't control the rain. So it's not even a question of maybe I haven't done enough. There are just some things that we can't control. But what we can control is how we respond. And we can choose an empowered response. That's about being unstoppable. that I'm not going to be stopped by these challenges. I'm not going to be stopped by this setback. I'm going to continue to find a way and forge ahead. And we've had a lot of stories of people who continued to try. They failed several times, quote unquote failed, because again, you know, what we define as failure is just is data telling us what doesn't work, telling us what to do next time, how to do it differently. And so we've heard stories of you know, great successes after a lot of lessons learned along the way. And so being courageous is a critical part of stepping forward and taking our place. Even if you don't want to risk yourself, in my experience, life will risk you. We can't hide from life. You know, the rain falls on the good, the bad, and the ugly, right? If you try to shield yourself from the bad, you'll end up shielding yourself from the good as well. It's just how life works. So our attitude needs to be more, take life with both hands. Bring it on. I can survive. I am here. I can survive. I'm a stand for fulfilling my potential, realizing my dreams. And whatever it takes, if I need to learn from someone, if I need to get these resources, if I need to ask these questions, if I need to have a bold conversation with my manager, or I need to be courageous in asking for the sale, right? Perhaps you've been spending $1 million with us and we need you to get to 10 million or 100 million. You know, that's a bold ask, right? That courage to get in that communication, that would make a huge difference. Because the reality is, everybody has fear, but usually what we fear is so far-fetched. If you think about it, think about the worst that can happen. Say you're in a situation where, you know, you have the nerves, you're afraid to take the step, etc. Think about the worst that can happen. The reality is, that probably won't happen. It's so far-fetched. And even if it did, you'd survive it. And so we're not existentially at risk. But without doing that work, we can magnify the fear and just get paralyzed. But if we have a clear vision and we know that we deserve it, this is what I'm about, this is what I want to create, that also helps us to transcend that fear. Because the pull of that vision is really strong and it pulls us in the direction that we need to go. And so I'll summarize by saying that each and every one of us is called to take charge and be a leader in our own lives. The tools are available. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. We don't need to go it alone. Help is available. We can leverage the relationships we have, the communities that we have, the tools that we have that are so prevalent in society today. But let's take a stand for ourselves. Let's take a long-term view to say, what are those things that I've been either putting off or I've been daunted by? You know, I would really like to crack this, but somehow I just haven't managed. Put a time to it. Maybe by the end of this year or by this time next year, my story will be different because I would have ticked all these boxes. When we take that long-term view, it's easy to take the steps, one step after the other. Sometimes we're so short-term focused that we think about, oh gosh, how am I going to make this happen? It's a lot of work. What I'm aspiring to is here. I'm here. It's just too much. And so I'm paralyzed or I procrastinate. But if we take a long-term view, and then even if it's, dedicate 30 minutes every week to that particular goal or an hour every week, if I do that consistently, by the end of this year or by this time next year, I would have moved. I wouldn't be in the same place. I would have moved forward. Life is a process of constant growth and learning, and we need to keep moving forward. And that, a lot of that is us challenging ourselves. doing the work, creating that picture, and then reaching out. And also reaching out with courage, with boldness, with a mindset that I deserve this. And if I don't do this, I'm shortchanging myself. I deserve to have my dreams fulfilled. I deserve to be the best version of myself. I'll end on that note, and thank you so much, everyone. I hope we take the exercises to heart, and I look forward to engaging with you at the happy hour. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, Juliet. That was a lovely speech. Hello, everyone. My name is Jen Seeger, and I work at Microsoft. I'm the chief of staff for the office, or for the president of the small, medium, and corporate business. And this is Keon, who is my partner from HR. Keon, did you?
Hello. Hello, everyone. How are we doing? Yeah. We're still holding up? Good, good. I'm Keon Johnson. I am the general manager of HR for the small, medium, and corporate digital sales HR organization. And Jen is one of my great partners. We're so excited to be with you today.
Yeah, it's been an awesome day. I've learned so much. Michelle Ward McGee, who is a part of my team at Microsoft and leads culture, she told me about this event last year, and I wasn't able to make it. This year, I heard about it. She was coming back, and we're a sponsor, and I said, I have to be there this year. I really want to participate and learn, and I got so much out of the conversations today, so many takeaways from the discussion. So I thank you for having me here. Thank you all for coming, and we would like to invite you all to join us at our reception this afternoon, or this evening, I guess. It's almost evening. And go ahead, Ken.
Yes, please join us. It is our pleasure. Hope we get the chance to have a chat with as many of you as we possibly can. Super excited tonight. Our spirits are presented by Beam Centauri. So I'm excited. We'll wrap up the day and look forward to seeing everyone bright and early tomorrow, right?
And I will say that the Microsoft folks, any Microsoft folks in the room, raise your hand. All right, so we're all going to be wearing sparkly rings. Mine is not on because I didn't want it to run out of sparkle for the reception. But please come talk to us about experiences that we have at Microsoft. I personally have been at Microsoft for 16 years. One of the best decisions I ever made was joining the company. It's just been a fabulous place to work, and I would love to talk to you about it. So thank you.
All right. Thanks, everyone. We'll see you out there.